So this is Stoke. There's three gangs of brickies on this site.
We're building a social housing, get it done.
Whatever we've got left on site is what we've got.
There's a nationwide shortage of cement. It's affecting sites up and down the country.
Been kicked out.
You might as well be homeless.
Bro, I basically am homeless, mate.
I'm dreading this, I am.
Hello?
Hello, how's it gone with you, mum?
Mate, it's not gone well, to be fair, Jack. I rang my mum, as you know, earlier, because I took your phone off, yeah? And I rang her, and she's basically said to me, yeah, you're not coming back. And same with my missus. I'm in a big rut, mate. I don't know where I'm staying at the minute. I've recently been kicked out of my mum's house because of me being a little fucker. I'll come live with you, Jack.
Well, there is that option. We'll have to get you a blow-up bed or something.
I was 18 years old, I just had a newborn baby. Ever since I started with the company, Jack's always looked after me. If I'm going through a bad patch, give Jack a bell, he's there. So, yeah, I need to try and get hold of my grandma. I need to see if I can stay at her house, because if I can't, I don't know what I'm going to do. You know what, you only get stronger, don't you, from things like this? Do you know what I mean? It makes you a bigger, better person, don't it, mate? I mean, I get to see my daughter at most weekends, but sometimes I don't, sometimes I do. It depends how me and her mum have been getting on. And things work out, things don't, but she's my goal to see her. I feel like she should be on EastEnders.
Oh, beep, beep, beep. Not used to that in my Clio. I'm just about to drive on site now for the first time in my new car, and I hope everyone likes it, because I like it.
Where's Georgia gone?
Oh, what? Ooh. Oh, she's getting dirty already.
Oh, my God.
They are some nice wheels.
Mate, that is a proper motor.
I think they quite like it. Probably not as much as me.
So you finally found the car that you wanted?
Yeah, it was
good time.
It was about time.
Took you about
it?
6 months.
It was, yeah. I know, yeah. But I waited for the right one.
Now, I always said to her, if you wait, the car will come, and it's coming. Yeah, it's a beast.
What's her name? What are you going to call her?
I haven't named her yet.
Sheila.
She needs a sexy name.
No, she's
Sheila's not sexy.
Or Sasha.
Sasha. Sasha? I quite like that. Oh. That's quite a nice name for her.
You know what I mean?
Hard work pairs off.
I know it's a lovely car, a lot of you, but are we going to work or what?
Yeah, we're going to have to, aren't we?
Go on, then. Come on.
Come on, Georgia. Georgia.
I'm coming. I'll park up now.
You lucky swine.
Whoop, whoop. Got my car. Nice.
Morning, guys. Hope you've all had a good weekend. Really need to get this arse done this week. Still out at Stoke-on-Trent. It's starting to have financial implications. We need them to top it out. That means getting to the top of the gable end and finishing it.
We've bought patching, so new bricklayer to help you. So put Georgia patch together on this gable.
Hopefully, bringing in the extra bricklayer, pull back the days that we lost last week.
Hi, Patch.
Go.
Hi, Patch.
I'm Patrick, I'm 24, and I'm a bricklayer. I live locally with my missus and my two kids. It's the first day I'm working on this site, and I don't know anybody on here, but I suppose that's the life of a bricklayer.
Which side do you want?
This one, if it's all right.
This one?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. All right. Yeah. Sort of got to get back to above here, as high as we can reach, and then it's jump up there, get that up to the peak then. What would you say, there's about 500 in this?
Yeah, I was going to say, yeah, good.
There's about 500 in this. Yeah, we'll get this done easy.
Right, Shag. He looks like Shaggy out of Scooby-Doo.
Scooby-Doo, yeah.
He says he don't mind, so I'm going to call him Shaggy.
As soon as I walked onto the site, straight away, Tom called me Shaggy, which is what a lot of people call me. They say I look like Shaggy. That'll probably be my nickname now, every time he sees me.
Told you, laugh of a bricklayer.
Laying bricks is what I like doing, so. You're building people's dream homes. You can build a house somebody moves into. It's quite a nice feeling. I'm 24 years old, and nobody can tell me anything different.
He's a really good lad. He knows his stuff. He's a good bricklayer. I'd say he's only been doing it for, I think it was 2 years, he said.
I'm young and I'm keen. I have got two kids, but I do well for my kids. I work hard for my kids. I do everything for them, so
aspect is really important to me, for people to know that I'm a young dad and I don't just come here for a laugh.
You ready, boss man? You ready? Film him all the time.
This week's a bit of a stressful one for me because next week I'm going on holiday and I plan on proposing to my missus.
Where are you going on holiday?
Tawyn.
Tawyn?
Yeah, Wales.
Really?
Yeah.
What part?
Golden Sands, it's called. Caravan park.
Lovely round there.
Hopefully I get the right moment, the right time. Picturesque moment, as they say. Yeah.
Give up, game over.
When it comes to building the brick wall, you have your string line, keep your wall straight. Literally, just a piece of string. So you've got your bricks, just about. And then make sure you've got your compo, your muck, your cement.
You tend to get 350 bricks out of a tub, something like that, 350, depends.
Get some gobbo for the lads then.
There's a lot of different names people call mortar. We all call it gobbo. You've got muck, you've got shit, you've got gear.
One finger runs through it nice like that, that's good compo.
I live at home with my partner, Natalia. Been together for 6 years now. We have two children, Scarlett and Jackson. Scarlett's 4, Jackson's 8 months old. I don't think I could be a bricklayer every day if I didn't have my missus to go home to. I'd have nobody rant to. I'd have nobody tell me problems to, or who I fell out with on site, or if I've messed something up, or if I've smashed it one day and I've done dead well and I can go home and I can tell her and she sat there and she's like, yeah, well done, babe.
I need to get off and get on this holiday. Work is so stressful at the moment.
Yeah.
I'm excited, though. I'm excited to have you open for a whole week.
Me too.
Nice and clean, no dirty boots, no dirty clothes.
Stinky feet.
Yeah.
She's seen me progress over the past 2 years. She saw me first time go on site and come home and say, like, I don't know what I'm doing, to now I've got my own work, I'm earning my own money, and she's proud of me.
Got it all over your face.
Even on my nose.
Not yet. You will have, though.
Hopefully I can find somewhere nice to pop the question. It's important to me because it's important to her. She wants that princess day. If I can give that to her, that'll give me a sense of satisfaction that I can make her happy and be happy myself at the same time. I want to marry her just as much as she wants to marry me, so I'm just hoping that she says yes.
How satisfying is this?
This is the Bricky's cake.
Grim.
We've got to get the gables up on the houses this week. We've got other trades booked in. The scaffold needs to come down and we need to get the landscaping done around the house because obviously these houses are ready for people to move in. So the quicker we get it done, the quicker people can move in and start making memories.
Cudder's here, it's all right. We'll get it done in a week, eh, Cudder?
Easy.
Cudder. God, where do I start?
I'm Cudder. I'm a bricklayer. I can't do this. My name's Cudder and I'm a bricklayer.
Everyone loves Cudder. You can't hate Cudder. He's always laughing. But sometimes he gets on your tits.
I love bricklaying because I feel free. So I don't have to think about anything else. just free. When I moved to UK, I was 15 years old. Life in Zimbabwe, the way I grew up, if you don't work hard, you'll starve. You will starve, for real. But if I compare life in UK and Zimbabwe, here is good. And if you work hard, you can achieve any dream.
You like saving, don't you, Cudder?
Huh?
You like saving your money, don't you?
I've got plans, really. Always working.
Oh,
always,
yeah, you don't stop. Saturday, Sunday, Monday.
My goal is to buy my own house.
Cudder,
Cudder, you got any updates about your ass?
I'm gonna do other one on Thursday.
Cudder has been trying very, very hard to buy a new house.
My dream house is I just want 3-bedroom house, driveway, and a space to build on.
Welcome to the annual Bricklaying World Championship.
1, 2, 3, 4!
Better than his proper work, that is.
You've got my control!
Yeah, it's got to be a 4. We're going to give him that a 4. It's actually quite good. I'm going to score that a 5.
A 5?
A 5.
Out of 10?
The winner of the Pyramid Challenge is Zach.
Yes!
The most important person in my life is definitely my daughter, Faith. She's the apple of my eye. She means everything to me. So, yeah, I get to see her most weekends. It depends how me and her mum have been getting on and stuff like that.
Hi, Bebe. I missed you. Hi. You a good girl? Not been at school this week, have you?
No school.
No school? Lucky you. What have you been doing?
Been to the zoo.
Was the giraffes?
Yeah.
How tall were the giraffes? Were they like tall like trees?
That
tall?
Up to the sky.
Up to the sky. That's good, isn't it? I wish I'd came there. I haven't been to a zoo in a long, long time.
Do you wish it was a giraffe?
I wish, well, it'd be good, wouldn't it? So you can get all the leaves off the top of the trees.
Yeah, but would you like it in this stump?
Getting so clever, aren't you? That's why I miss you so much when I'm at work, because then I come home and I get to learn all these new things you've been learning.
So, yeah, it's nice to meet with Paige, clear things up, have a little bit of a chat, and we do genuinely care for each other. I miss her a lot, do you know what I mean?
It must be hard away from her.
It does my head in, but...
She does miss her.
I miss her. Me falling out with the ex, I mean, I lost a lot leaving her. It's contributed into the predicament I'm in.
Yeah, I think sometimes things need to fall apart to fall together. I just don't think it's the best time to be living under the same roof at the moment. I just don't think it's a healthy environment for Faith and for our own mental health.
Got a bit crap, didn't it?
It did. And I just think it made us really not like each other. And I think we do now.
I mean, obviously, I'm not going to be coming back to yours or anything anytime soon, so... I need to be sorting out a place for me and Faith. I'm in.
I think you're a really good dad with Faith. Naturally, you do such a good job to say you didn't have your own father figure to look up to. And she's so excited to see you. And she knows Friday is Daddy Day. Yeah. So she leaps out of bed on Friday because
well,
she knows.
I look forward to it as well. So.
Just honestly, she's just a mini you.
God. That's what we want. Now, I had a bit of a rough upbringing. My mum was absolutely brilliant, but other things in my life that turned it upside down a bit, it made me have a bit of a bad start.
Before Faith, I had no goals in life, do you know what I mean? And now, like, got something to actually treasure.
She's my goal to see her every weekend, so yeah.
I'm ready to buy my own house.
I've seen lots and lots of houses. I'm hoping this one, that's the one.
Yeah, I like it. You know, there's a driveway, there's a garage as well. Maybe I could extend this way. I'm gonna go inside, finger crossed.
Like every day I'm thinking about it, like, you know what? It's time for me to get my own house. This time is ticking.
What a nice house. When I was a kid, you know, my dream was to buy a house. You know what I mean? Now I'm ready to get this one, so that's a big achievement. I'm telling you, if I get this one. That's it now, kids. This is life changing, I'm telling you. I'll be proud of myself. Forget it.
So
on then, boys.
You had asparagus last night. Did you know that's an aphrodisiac? Do you know what aphrodisiac is? Come on,
I've heard of it, but I can't.
It fucking gives you hard on, don't it? It's like, it's like turns you on, makes you like.
Asparagus?
Yeah, asparagus.
This isn't what we need on camera.
Hello? I know the house market is really demanding.
Everything's so good. Everything's so good.
I'm willing to offer more to make sure I get the house I wanted.
Yeah, I would like to make an offer. 144, 145. Because I'm going a little bit higher, just a little, you know what I mean?
I've given my offer. I'm confident, but it could go either way.
Yes, yes. Then after that, please, can you call me? Okay, thank you very much. Cheers. Cheers. Bye-bye.
Finger crossed, everything crossed. I hope I'll get the house.
Got the ring coming on Wednesday.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, are you nervous?
A little bit.
Obviously, Georgie knows that I'm going to propose to Tal. She's told me just be confident, just do it, just get it over and done with. Don't be scared. Can't help that, but it's good bit of advice. Nobody else has said that, don't be scared.
Planned it out and everything. I wanted to happen on the beach, on the sea line. See if I can get it right. Right, first time.
Getting married, Tom?
Huh?
Getting married?
Don't.
He's got a ring coming. He's taking her away next week.
Worst mistake you'll ever make in your life, that is, mate. At the end of the day, it's a bit of paper with some writing on, isn't it? I mean, it don't mean nothing. If you love someone, you love them, don't you? You don't need to get married to prove that. Marriage is bullshit. You'd never, ever get me married.
It's not.
It fucking is. It's a bit of paper.
Nah, it's not bullshit. It's cute. He's got his wedding ring on the way.
You know what it's called? Engagement ring on the way. Bowing down to your bird, that is.
Oh, come on.
Don't listen to what I say, mate. I can't keep a missus, so I don't listen to what I fucking say, lad.
Some people rush into it, don't they? I feel you shouldn't get married unless you've at least been together 6 years plus.
I've been kids.
We've been together 6 years.
There we go, exactly. Rooting for him, bless him.
A lot of people have said marriage is a bad mistake, but that's their experience, I suppose. I haven't had that experience, I haven't been married yet, so I'm not going to let that hold me back.
Get married, Tom.
Oh, fuck that.
What?
Bad enough working with him.
Look at me sexy body.
So then, mate, it's not looking good, really. I know we're running low on gobbo, and it looks like by about 1:30 today we're going to be completely out. I know it's not really your fault, but what do you want me to do with the men? Do you want me to lay them off? What do you want me to do?
In all fairness, Jack, the only thing I can really say at this point, I mean, obviously, you know I've been on to the Muck Company.
Yeah, I understand that, mate.
All I can say for the time being is use up what they've got, yeah. Whatever they've got left. Tomorrow morning, let's get them back in, let's have a good tidy up, let's get all that sorted, and then we can just hope. By the time that they've finished all that, you know, a bit of gobbo will turn up.
All right, cheers for that, mate.
All right, no
thank
worries,
you.
Jack. Cheers, mate.
We've had a nightmare when it comes to the mortar situation. It's starting to come to a head now, and it's meaning that we're losing progress, and obviously bricklayers are losing money.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm good, how are you?
Not bad. We've got a little bit of a problem.
Well, what is it?
We're running low on mortar.
That's not good, is it?
Not really, mate, but there's a shortage, there's not much we can do about it, to be fair.
No, I don't know, because to be honest, I'm losing now. That's what I can say, I'm losing now.
I understand that, mate, but there's nothing we can do. If the plant says it's not coming, but we'll do our best to get some.
I get angry, you know what I mean? I get angry. It's like missing someone's wages.
What about tomorrow?
I'm hoping it's coming, mate, that's all I can say.
That's not good, is it?
Not really, mate.
No.
It's obviously not gone down well because they've got bills to pay and they need to make money. So us as a company and me as a manager, we're going to have to find a solution and come up with a way that we could carry on building.
Don't know what's going to happen over the next few days, but I can see that at some point there might be a standstill unless we can get some compo.
Right now, if there's no compo, what am I supposed to do? You know what I mean? That's not good. That's not good at all. I'm losing money.
How much have you got down today, Georgia?
About 500.
Forget work anyway. I can't bother to talk about work anymore.
No.
What are you up to this weekend?
Oh, I can't wait to go home.
I'm glad you've got your own bed. Obviously, I did have my own place, didn't I? But I mean,
yeah.
Everything's just. It went from that, Georgia,
to
real quick to in that. A matter of minutes. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? But
I was having a bit of a hot talk with Georgia about the home situation and Paige, my ex-girlfriend.
So are you going to like patch things up?
The reason why I was at my mum's anyway was because me and the girlfriend was having a break. So yeah. I am 25, and it is about time I get my own place. Not just for my interests. For my daughter's interest as well.
How old is your daughter?
She's five now. She's five in May. Big girl now. I said to her, I says, can you spell me some words then? Because she can spell and read now. She's really, really clever. I said, go on, spell daddy for me.
Yeah.
And she went, D-A-D-D-Y. Like that.
Easy,
and I went, no, that's flu. How can you do that, five? I should go to read now and I'm 24. Do you know what I mean? She takes after her mum. Her mum's really clever.
So what about your missus, or I don't know what you want to call her now, or?
She's still, like, the love of my life, should I say. I think I want to probably give it another go with her. Then if it don't work out, so be it.
It don't,
you know
what I
mean? So be it.
So we've got a few things to sort out, then.
I've got a missus, I've got parents, I've got a house situation. That's it, isn't it?
Tom's a lovely lad. He treats me like a sister, and he even says that, and I get on with him so well. I don't know where he's going to go home on the weekend. I don't know. I'll have to just take him home with me, won't I? Try to give him to my dad.
Morning, everyone. I'd hate to be the bearer of bad news, but the mortar plant is shutting down from today. So today will be our last delivery of mortar for the foreseeable future.
You're joking?
No.
Is this serious or what?
Genuine.
You just want to go home when it's like this. You just want to go home.
If we haven't got any compo, we can't lay. If we don't lay, we don't make money.
Yeah, there's going to be a lot of pissed off people today. Not happy.
No muck, can't lay, can't earn money. Bricklayers just go home.
There's a lot of stigma based around the building industry that we're all big, hard men who don't have any worries, but it's like you could see on the faces, in the back of their minds, they're thinking, I'm going to earn, I'm going to pay my mortgage. A lot of them have got children. It's a thing in this industry, and this is where it all comes back to, like, mental health and stuff like that, and people struggling with it. We struggle just as much as anyone else.
Who's up for a game of cricket?
Me and the lads have made a ball out, some tinfoil, and got 4-2, and, yeah, we're going to have a few games of cricket.
Keep it in the realms of health and safety, and we're safe to play.
Cut! Yes! Definitely has its upsides, having lack of mortar.
You're shit!
Gotcha!
Gotcha!
Oh, yes! Yes! I love fucking Sydney!
Everyone's having a really good time, it's a good laugh. It's keeping morale high when we've got no mortar and obviously taking people's minds off not earning no money.
Catch!
Catch!
Yes! We've lost our ball now. That's the only one we've got. Beautiful game that was. Kudo! Kudo, we're loading out top and all. We've got no compo anyway, so we may as well just load it out, haven't we?
Okay, boss man. Look, we'll do whatever you ask me to do, boss.
It's Stewie, look!
No way.
Stewie!
Oh, what? You'll never guess what. The mortar has just appeared.
Yeah, start earning our money again. Just get the compo out.
Let's get laying.
Right, it's the creme. Got a creme.
Yeah.
That is like cheese spread, that.
When you lay a last brick, when you look back, and it's amazing.
The last brick.
When I finish building something, it makes me feel proud knowing that I can produce something that's quality.
Right, you getting this? We're done. Yay. And that's the last part of your house. So, yeah, it's the most joyful part, 100%.
What happened over the weekend?
So, yeah, the weekend's not turned out as bad as I thought it was going to be. I ended up going to my grandma's, grandma and granddad's. They've let me stay there.
Got the pool out, got my daughter here, having some fun. All is good. Happy days.
Plan is save a bit of money while I'm there and, yeah, get my own gaff eventually. So, I mean, me and Faye spend a lot of quality time together. She just loves being with her dad. I love everything about her. I mean, just seeing her little face light up when she sees me, that means the world to me. Having faith made me realise that there's more to life than hating on what you got brought up with. I mean, you can make something of yourself no matter where you come up from. When I was a little shit before I had my daughter, I was getting in trouble with the police. It was mainly fighting, and you look back on them and you think, I wish I never did it. I dread to think going back to the stage like that. I'd never, ever do it again. You get it? You ready? Reel it like that, look, when you've got a fish.
We're going to make a real fisherman out of you now, aren't we? You're going to be master fisher soon.
That's it. Yeah, my kid's so young, I had her at 18, but if I'm honest, I wouldn't change it for the world. It changed me as a person, changed me, my life, everything. It made me who I am today, and I could not be happier. That's it.
I wonder what I'm going to get.
I wonder as well.
Cuddy, you got any updates about your ass?
Mate, I'm in pain right now, you know what I mean? I've been on pain, let me down all so many times, so...
Last night, I built a house, but there was lots of people. They're really interesting, right? I've been in that situation before, so I'm not 100% sure if I'm gonna get it.
Cool lad, cool lad. If I've got it, what can I say? Drinking champagne.
Are we celebrating if you get hard?
I have to celebrate, man. You see, happy all the way. Tell my mom and dad, mom.
Good on, something will pop up, I'm telling you. Something will come around and you'll fall in love with it, and then you'll offer him, keep offering him money, you know what I mean?
Hello?
Yeah, is that, hold on.
I did view a house yesterday. To be honest, I really like the house. Oh, I think that's my final offer.
So how did it go?
It was nice. It was really nice. The sea was dead nice. It was quiet. You could just hear the waves, the seagulls. There was nobody about. We just sat down and I just thought to myself, this is it. This is the time. Got down on one knee and then I asked the question.
What did she say?
She said yes. Result. Keep growing now and look to the future. I've got a wedding to pay for, so now I've got to go and lay some bricks.
Welcome to the site at Northampton.
Going local.
It's like that old saying, innit? You don't shit.